By above 500,000 votes. I want President Edgar Chagwa Lungu and his supporters to know that President Edgar Chagwa Lungu is daydreaming. He cannot win this election whatsoever. He can't win. Even if they try to manipulate, the vote gap will be too wide. No one wants to play around with the will of the people. He can't win. President Edgar Chagwa Lungu would only have won this election by more than 500,000 votes if he had kept his word, which he gave the nation when he opened parliament in 2017, where he said, "My government will create more than 500,000 jobs." He has created none. He has actually cost many young people jobs. You have seen what is happening around. Go to Mandahi, go to Arcades, go to many of these places. Shops that were employing young people are closing down because of the collapse of the Kwacha. The only thing President Edgar Chagwa Lungu has successfully achieved to prove that his words can be relied on is on the issue of lacking vision. Told the nation he has no vision. The nation has now seen that he was just being sincere, that he has no vision. He has plunged the nation into an economic crisis. We are an international laughingstock, failing to pay just an interest. Jobs lost, businesses closing. So on that one, I think we can rely on him. He meant it, we've seen it. Because seeing is believing. The economy had already collapsed. It was already in ICU before COVID. And who has caused that? Policies of Patriot Front. Policies of consumption and not investment and production and prudent utilization of public resources. That is the reason. So, jobs are closing down. Meaning, we are now at negative. The 500,000 plus jobs President Edgar Lungu promised, we are now into negative. These, if he had created these 500,000 jobs, then he would have had the higher moral ground to say, I'm winning because I've created these jobs. So, President Edgar Chagwa Lungu will lose by more than 500,000 votes. Because the young people are not happy with him. Even those young people who are employed, many of them have very poor conditions of service. Look at what is happening. If you go to many of these shops, there is no adherence to minimum wage regulation. Many young people are just waiting there to keep time as they wait for something else to do. As a young person and other employees, the moment you enter a shop, this Chinese or Lebanese will grab your phones and hold those phones from 8 hours when you report for work up to 17 hours when you knock off. Now what if there's an emergency at home? How do you get to be notified? There is no government monitoring how people who are employed in the informal sector are being mistreated, including adherence to minimum wage law. I'm here to report that HH and the UPND Alliance would want the young people especially and those who are working in the informal sector to know that once this alliance forms government, the law shall be followed to the latter. And it is not difficult to follow the law to the latter. You have to do collateral and achieve collateral obligations. Presently, Patriotic Front cannot enter any shop or any farm to see if Patriotic Front government, to see if there is adherence to minimum wage.